are so important. Together, we are going to persevere. I'm so happy to see many friends and new faces today. Thank you so much to Live Casino Hotel for hosting us in your beautiful venue, amazing food, and lots of fun during this press conference and after. I have the privilege of serving in Nova, BC as the Vice President and happen to now be the longest reigning in this VietFest. In 2018, I moved to Baltimore, Maryland. I felt that I had lost my Vietnamese identity because I didn't know anyone and I didn't see many faces that looked like me. In 2019, I found out about Mobile DC and the Miss VietFest pageant. I was hesitant in signing up to participate in the pageant, but I am so glad I did. While the pandemic has affected my reign, these past 2 years, I have had the privilege of being able to participate and volunteer for a variety of Vietnamese organizations, as well as expanding my Vietnamese network, meeting all of you, and also working towards fulfilling my pageant platform, which is mentorship, sailing for success. One of my biggest achievements so far is creating the Nobel DC MGM program. Mentorship is something I have always valued, and I have seen many Vietnamese students who go through college and don't have a mentor or someone who can help guide them. So the Nobel DC MGM program pairs Vietnamese college students in the area with Vietnamese professionals who have the same or similar career interests as the students do. Each month, we have been hosting workshops on different professional development topics such as resume and interview skills, effective communication, and we also hosted a virtual speed networking event with local Vietnamese leaders. Next month, we will be completing the first year of our program, and we're excited to award 2 students with scholarships, which will be announced at VietFest. Again, Nobel DC has been such a great organization that I've been a part of. I'm so blessed to be part of this family. I have gained so many new friends and skills, and I'm really looking forward to VietFest this year as we bring our community together. You know, despite it, this last 2 years, I'm so excited to see all of you here and look forward to seeing you at VietFest August 20th and 29th. And together, we can move our community forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Jenny. So, as you know, VietFest can't happen unless we have sponsors, unless we have support. And Maryland Live Casino, which we used to be called, but now it's Live Casino Hotel, has been with us since day one. They're as much part of the VietFest family. And you know what? We will continue this relationship to whenever you guys are around, okay? But please, I would like to introduce you to the general manager, Anthony Barranca of Maryland Live Casino, to say a few words. Thank you.
Thank you, Bobby. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to the beautiful Hall of Live. My name is Anthony Barranca. I am the general manager here at Live Casino Hotel. Let's start with giving our team members here that served us food today. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you guys. Thank you very much. I want to personally welcome everyone to today's press conference, our formal kickoff for VietFest 2021, the East Coast's largest annual celebration honoring the Vietnamese community, their incredible culture, and their exceptional talent. We are very proud, we're so proud, to continue supporting this annual celebration. And it's certainly a pleasure to see everyone here in person today. Next month's event is all about coming together to honor and celebrate the Vietnamese community, which has been incredibly supportive of Live Casino and Hotel since we first opened our doors all the way back in 2012. I want to especially thank Bobby Lee and the National Organization for Vietnamese American Leadership, who work tirelessly each year to host this festival and to preserve Vietnamese cultural heritage in the Washington metro area. We look forward to next month's showcase of Vietnamese heritage within our local community, along with crowning Mr. and Miss VietFest. From all of us here at Live Casino and Hotel, thank you so much for joining us today, and enjoy the celebration in honor of VietFest 2021. Thank you very much.
All right, next, well, first I'd like to say VietFest has been around since 2011, and it takes a lot of volunteers, it takes a lot of people to really make it happen. And I'll tell you what, we've gone through a lot of different volunteers. Some have grown up, some have got married and moved on. But there are some core people that still here from day one. So I would like to bring our current board members and our committee members on the stage so you can see the people behind VietFest. So we have Nick LaFemme, who is the co-president and who's been here since day one. We have Jenny Nguyen, who you spoke to, who just spoke. Not only she's Miss VietFest, but now she's the Vice President of the Noval DC. And then we have Kim Nguyen, who has been here since day one. Now she's very busy, family with a lot of kids, but she's always there whenever we need her. Okay. And also Alyssa Nguyen, who's not here, but Alyssa has been volunteering with us since she was, 14 to 15, right? And now I believe she's 22, and she's the secretary, but she was a super volunteer. So as you can see, VietFest is more than just a festival. We are building leaders. We're working with young kids and building them, giving them titles, giving them responsibility, and they grew with us. And a lot of times, a lot of volunteers go off, go to college, get a job, and they use us as a reference. And for me, that's what I'm proud of with VietFest and Noval DC, is the fact that they've grown with us and they remember their experience with us. And we vouch that for them. Next, we have Tiffany Nguyen, who is our public relations director. She's been with us for a number of years now, and I hope that I know she'll be with us for a long time. And Krishna, who always handles the talent, the entertainment, and he's been here with us since day one. We have Heather Tran, who is our volunteer coordinator. I don't know if Heather's here yet. We have Laura Dawn Myers, who is our Miss VietFest co-director, and along with her, Kimberly Nguyen, who is also the Miss VietFest co-directors. And then we have Joe Fu, who is our Mr. VietFest co-director with Minyang Nguyen, Mr. VietFest co-director. I don't think Minyang is here. And then we have Elizabeth Ivey, who handles all our website, posters, all the marketing, digital stuff. I don't know how to do any of that, so I'm thankful that we have her to be able to help with all of that. And of course, we have Robert Pham, who does our photos, along with Billy Kuhn, who's been there since day one, taking photos, doing videos, and working on a lot of graphics. So next, I'm going to bring Nick to the podium to talk briefly about what VietFest is about.
Take a photo. All right. Thank you, Bobby, for the introduction. As one of the co-founders of Noval DC, or the last OG, as the young folks may understand, it's such a proud moment to be up here and see a crowd like you all tonight. that I mean today. Obviously, the last year and a half has been difficult, but it's good to finally see the people who I consider my family in this room. I moved to DC just like Jenny without knowing anybody in this area, and it's the people in this room that helped make Novel DC, as well as my life in the DC area, wonderful. So thank you for that. We started from a table no bigger than the ones you're sitting at, and here we are 9 years later with VietFest, where our mission has been to help elevate our community by promoting new leadership, young leadership in the next generation, as well as promoting Vietnamese culture to the American mainstream. And that's why we have VietFest, right? A celebration that brings us all together, not just all generations of the Vietnamese American community, but one that can invite and include and share what's best about Vietnamese culture to all non-Vietnamese people in the DC, Maryland, Virginia area, where folks can learn about our stories and our history, where they can try new foods that they may have not had before, where they can meet new friends and learn from one another. And in the world that we've seen these last year and a half, not just from the pandemic, but the rise in violence against Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders, it's moments like these, it's events like these, that bring us together and give us an opportunity to learn about one another and our common humanity and to celebrate, because obviously life is precious and we should enjoy it well, live most that we can, and to help one another when we can. And so, as folks have, for those of you who have been here before, you'll know that VietFest is a place where we can eat, but also see a lot of entertainment, which you'll learn about, as well as a lot of eating competitions and a variety of other things. And so I will turn it over to Bobby to talk about our culture this year, or not our culture, but our theme this year. And that's why we'll learn more about the theme, and you'll understand why.
Yeah, Nick almost gave away the theme, but it's okay. All right, well, you know, every year we always try to come up with a theme for VietFest. I mean, before we had, like, East meets West, we had the Great Regions of Vietnam. But, you know, this year, it's a little bit different. And, you know, for a year and a half, we've been very isolated due to the pandemic. And we haven't had, you know, big events like this to bring people together, you know. So ever since Virginia decided to open up everything, you know, that's when we said, you know, we gotta have VietFest. We gotta, you know, continue to do this to bring everything kind of back to normal. You know, I don't know what the normal is, but it'll be the new normal. So our theme this year is back to the culture. Okay. So what does that mean? Basically, when we think about culture, culture is what brings communities together. So, you know, VietFest is a Vietnamese festival, but we celebrate it with other cultures. We have performances from, you know, the Chinese community, Greek community, you know, American community, all different communities. And culture is what brings community together, and, you know, what better than, you know, VietFest. So that's why theme for this year, and I'm looking for, you know, a lot of cultural performances. If you know any communities that have those performances, we'd like to showcase at our festival. And, you know, every year we try to encourage a lot of Vietnamese to wear our traditional áo dài, to be part of, you know, the festival, to celebrate, you know, our Vietnamese heritage. You know, everybody knows of the Vietnamese áo dài. So anybody that comes to VietFest, ladies, please, I encourage everybody to wear áo dài this year, like every year, to really, you know, show them this is part of our culture, okay? And of course, we always decorate it, you know, with things that really speaks loudly about Vietnam. This year, like I say, it's back to the culture. Okay. So next, I'm going to bring Jenny up to discuss about the food showcase, the food eating contest. Jenny? This year particularly is harder for us to find sponsors. You know, for example, you know, we have ANA, we have Cathay Airlines. They can't sponsor us this year even if they want to because the flights are shut down from Dallas. So, you know, and the pandemic has affected so many different businesses where, you know, there's a lot of uncertainties. But, you know, this year we have New York Life as our sponsor. We have Union Home Mortgage. You know, we also have agency all the way in the back there. She helps with auto insurance and home and life insurance. And, you know, we have a lot of sponsors like Healing Center, Microsoft, and then we have our media sponsors like Tumacino, we have SBTN, we have Big TV, we have Pod and Dome TV, we have other newspapers, business newspaper that sponsor us. So I'm asking everybody here if they know of any sponsors that want to advertise at a festival, at a prime location at Tyson Sport Mall for 2 days. And we welcome them. We also need a lot of vendors selling food, or if there's an exhibition vendor that wants to promote their business. So because, you know, COVID has affected so many businesses, this year I'm going to give a discount to those food vendors that want to promote their restaurants, or also those exhibition vendors that want to come out. So you can contact me at 703-835-6040, or go onto the VietFest.com website, or email me at bobbylee@gmail.com, and I will definitely set you guys up. This year we have more space. The Lord Taylor at Tyson's Corner has closed up, so now I have more room inside for exhibition vendors to be at. and it's out of the hot weather. It's actually inside and it's very nice. So please, we're still opening for more sponsors and vendors. If you guys know any, send them our way so that we can make this event very, very successful. So next I would like to bring Christian O up to the stage to discuss our entertainment for this year. Christian has been there with us since day one, and he does a great job by bringing talent here for the different entertainment that we provide every year. So please, Christian O.
Hey, round of applause for Bobby. You guys don't realize how hard of a worker he is. He's just amazing. Him and Nick have been running this organization incredibly. But a shout out also, where's Lauren? Lauren O from the Asian marketing team. Hey, Lauren. No relation, even though her last name is OH. I just want to talk about two things. Number one, VietFest Got Talent is an annual tradition that we've been doing where we create a talent competition, and there are cash prizes, first, second, and third place. So if you know anyone who's got some sort of talent, maybe it's juggling, maybe it's magic, maybe it's comedy, maybe it's dancing, singing, rapping, whatever it may be, make sure they sign up and go to our website at VFS or on our Facebook page, and there is a link. It's actually tinyurl.com/VGT2021. So again, cash prizes, any type of talent, whatever it may be. And then make sure you register before, I think the deadline is August 21st. So make sure you do that before the following weekend, which is our actual dates, 28th and 29th. Next up is celebration. You know, Bobby was talking about community. The one thing that I think is so important, I've been here in the Washington, D.C. area for now over 20-some years, and it's great that this festival actually doesn't just focus on the Vietnamese community, but of bringing together all the various different communities. Some of you may know I've been very involved with the Queen Society of Maryland Chorus Festival, the Asian Festival down in Washington, D.C., Fiesta Asia, where we block off 3rd Street through 6th Street along Pennsylvania Avenue. So I've helped garner and establish a lot of these festival events. We've done K-pop and other things here at Maryland Live. So again, shout out to Lauren and the Asian marketing team. Please, they've been a huge supporter of a lot of things Asian. So I would say rise to the occasion if you either love or love being Asian. So make sure you guys really, really come out. The Celebration Showcase is our local talent showcase. So we bring performers from not just within the VMB, even sometimes outside the VMB, to make sure that they come and represent, because we don't get a lot of representation in entertainment, and we're still striving to improve and continue that. So please come out, enjoy the show, celebrate and support your Asian American talent and fellow performers. And a lot of times as parents, we don't really pressure or push our kids to pursue artistic pursuits, but I thank those parents that do and support a kid who wants to be a b-boy, a girl who wants to be a singer, you know, whatever it may be. Make sure that you're supporting all the various different talents out there. So again, thank you. That's my time. You guys, I'll see you at VFS.
Is in Vietnamese and American newspapers,
radio stations, putting up flyers all around Eaton Center, and of course, social media, especially Facebook. This is a community effort, so please help us share this event on your social media and your network. VietFest is open to everyone, and we always love seeing new people experience our festival. If you also know of any restaurants or businesses who would like to participate in the festival, whether it be being a vendor, sponsor, or any other capacity, please bring them to our team. The pandemic has affected many of the businesses and the restaurants in our community, and we want to do what we can to help uphold them, promote them, and advertise them during this time. VietFest is a great way for our community to come together and support each other. Now, to the other fun areas of VietFest. I'd like to highlight that VietFest, one of my favorite parts, is the Mr. VietFest and Miss VietFest badges. While we are not having contestants competing for these titles this year, we have something else in store for all of you. I would like to welcome Joe Wu, who was one of our directors for Mr. VietFest. Joe has been very involved in our Vietnamese community and has put a lot of time into making Mr. VietFest as successful as it is today. Please give it up for Joe.
I would love to see everyone to next month for our event that we're having. sure, and that we can create something more for the table and bring more like awareness and bring more to what the community has to offer. So thank you guys.
You want those beautiful lights, Tom? Mr. Charming for 2019, and I'm just giving an incredible statement of how our experiences shape us within Mr. VietFest. I came here as a kid to the United States and came here in 2004, and so I always wanted to give back to the community. It was something that my parents have been putting down that on me and making sure that I am involved in my church as well as community. And so when I heard VietFest, of course, I was aware that I wasn't really into pageantry, but I wanted to give it a try, and I wanted to make sure that people like me, people that look like me, are involved and give back to the community as much as possible, and that's why I joined VietFest, and I want to make sure that folks that are Vietnamese men and women are confident, as well as knowledgeable, in not just, you know, our daily social life, but also political life as well. That's why I want to join VietFest, is to not only give back, but to make sure there's a movement that people can be educated and be motivated to be involved in, not to serve our country as well as serve the Vietnamese community. So the relationship that I have built within the VietFest has been amazing. And like Bobby, just to add on what Bobby said, the references that the VietFest has provided has been incredible. And because of VietFest, I was able to serve as a speaker at my works, Asian American Pacific Month, and I was able to reference VietFest as that. And because of VietFest, I was just had this confidence as well as this ability to mindset and motivation to always be involved and serve the community. So thank you so much for your time. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Steven. I was in 2017 to be a VietFest and hard act to follow, and you're not the only one from where you're at. So, you know, truth be told, I was sitting up here trying to figure out what I wanted to say and to add to it, but I think I'm going to stick with representation. It's just so important, you know, just growing up here and being able just to see someone that looks like you and kind of represent themselves in an unspoken, you know, confidence. And I think that being able to participate in VietFest really put myself out there with so many people, make so many friends along the way, really kind of helped develop that kind of unspoken confidence. And, you know, mostly, you know, we can say a lot of things to go through life, but most of what we carry forward is how we present ourselves, the smile, the wear on our face, while we stand up and come and face adversity. So that's something that I think reflects in our mission and really hope to pass on to the new generation. So thank you so much for attending today.
And all you guys can look at, I'm going to have to do something about that real quick. 2019, Mr. Tappet Jesse. So just a little thing I want to talk about is pretty much the community of what Mr. VietFest has to offer. The biggest thing over here is that a lot of people I've met throughout the entire time when I did my practice sessions with them, when I went ahead and did after work sessions or anything to help brushing up on my Vietnamese, because I speak very little Vietnamese, but I try my best. And the biggest thing is community brings people together to show them about the culture, about the roots, about how to spread awareness, and also to show people, hey, a lot of people in the Vietnamese community, you know, we tend to be shy, talk around a lot. We want to showcase that, you know, just on both sides, especially the men's community as well, we're not shy, we're not here to just not talk about simple things about our background or anything. We want to showcase, hey, we're out here, we're represented, we're different. We want to see that everyone knows about Vietnamese men as well. VietFest is definitely there to promote those things. And as part of the community, when everybody was with us, I saw that, hey, there was a big change, and that everybody was bonded together, and we had those strong bonds even after VietFest was over. So as a community, I see that as something that's very special. I want every Vietnamese, you know, male who's old enough to enter the competition, to form those bonds and create long-lasting relationships. And just wanted to share that with everyone so they can strive forward to do something better for themselves and everyone around. Thank you.
Different volunteers. As you can see, our special volunteers, they do also get our signature lime green VietFest t-shirt. And then you'll also get free meals throughout the day while you're volunteering. And of course, if you do need community service hours signed off, we'll be more than happy to sign those off for you as well. If you have any questions for that, you can also scan our QR code here if you're interested in looking at the volunteer code link. Or you can also visit our VietFest website to sign up. So if you're not convinced yet to volunteer or kind of being interested in going to the VietFest itself, we do have a recap video that we're going to show to everyone that should bring back some good memories or also give you a sneak peek of what is to come for the next month.
Thank you, Jenny.
So, everybody's heard what's going on this year with VietFest. This is when the work starts, and we need all your help. We need your help to let everybody know that VietFest is happening on August 28th and 29th. Let everybody know that we are still looking for vendors and sponsors to be part of our festival. And if there's any cultural performances that you know of that we can showcase at VietFest, please, I welcome all types of performances. So I'd like to thank everybody for putting your time out today and coming here to our press conference, and a special thanks to Maryland Casino Hotel for hosting this event at such a nice venue and with such good food and service. And just remember, you see this whole place here? They not only do concerts, if you guys want to bring your weddings here, or any events, whether it's a birthday party, anything, Maryland Live is open for any of that, okay? Maybe we can do some Asian weddings here. I mean, look how nice this is. They have like, what was it, 6 to 8 restaurants where you can choose different foods from different nationality. So keep that in mind, folks, that they're open, all their facilities, to do any kind of events that you may want, maybe even anniversaries, wedding, you name it, okay? So please give Maryland Live a round of applause for providing all of this for us today. Thank you. So now our press conference has ended, and I believe you guys have some people there to give out vouchers for a $25 slot play, and I hope all of you guys win a lot of money. But if you lose, it's not our fault, okay? All right, enjoy the rest of your day. And I would like the committee and the board to come up here and take a picture with the GM of Maryland Live. Mr. Anthony, can you come up and take a picture with us? And even... come on, guys, come on up. Let's take a picture. And thank you, everybody, and enjoy the rest of your day. Yes, everybody, you guys can come up too. Take a picture with us. Please, don't be shy. Thank you.
handle, I guess.
Okay.